What's rockin', Rocky Top? It's Miles here at the Music Minute, where I talk about music that I think you will enjoy. Today I'm going to be talking about the new 1975 record, Notes on a Conditional Form. The 1975 is a band based out of Cheshire, who have established a well-known reputation for themselves since their debut album titled The 1975 was released in 2013. With each release, it feels like the band has found a new sound for them and they consistently evolve. This is most notable on their latest release, Notes on a Conditional Form, which was released on the 22nd of May. I have anticipated the release of this album since 2018, when it was announced shortly after their previous album, A Brief Inquiry into Online Relationships, had come out. Upon first listen, I found myself absolutely floored. I did not know what to expect, but every single from the album that they had released had a different sound every time, leading me to believe that there was going to be a clashing of genres throughout the album, and I was absolutely right. This album breaks the fourth wall when it comes to genre by having songs that span from punk rock, alt rock, UK garage, all the way to a couple songs that have a country sound to them. Now, I do not think this was an accident, because in a recent interview frontman Matty Healy did with Pitchfork, he stated that Notes on a Conditional Form is the last 1975 record for ages, meaning the band probably wanted to step out of their comfort zones and get everything they wanted to do musically out of the way so they could officially close this chapter. Notes on a Conditional Form is no joke. Consisting of 22 songs in a hefty time of an hour and 20 minutes, it is not exactly the easiest thing to listen to, but that is not a bad thing. As I mentioned earlier, there is a smorgasbord of genres that will grab your attention one way or another. I've listened to this album a few times from start to finish, and I found myself loving it more and more each time. I'm not saying you should do the same, but I would recommend listening to this album in its entirety at least once. If you do not find yourself having the time to do that, I have some standout tracks for you to check out to make it a little easier. I can honestly say it was difficult for me to narrow it down to just three tracks, so I broke my own rules and decided to throw an extra track in the mix. The first song would have to be Frail State of Mind, which was one of the singles released for this album earlier this year. This track is the perfect example of the UK garage vibe I mentioned earlier. The lyrics are not necessarily the happiest material-wise, but the music itself is enough to make anyone dance and feel good. The second song would have to be Then Because She Goes, which is personally my favorite off of this album. It carries a very nostalgic 90s feeling, reminding me of classic bands such as Third Eye Blind, Oasis, and even New Radicals. It is one of the shorter songs on this album, but that does not make it any less significant. Definitely check this one out. The third song would have to be Playing on My Mind. This is one of the softer songs on the album, being mainly acoustic, but a very beautiful song nevertheless. It has additional vocals from Phoebe Bridgers, who appears on numerous tracks on this album. It sticks out to me because of how natural Maddie and Phoebe sound together, which makes this song even more significant to me. The last song would have to be Guys. This song is a very wholesome song about the love Maddie shares for his bandmates, who are also his best friends. This song has a very soft feeling to it, somewhat going back to the classic 80s sound they carried when they first started, but more mature. It is confusing to explain, but you'll know what I mean when you listen to it. And I just wanted to point out that when I looked at the liner notes of the record, it blew my mind to see George Daniel, who is the drummer of the band, having a lot of credit on the record, from producing an entire instrumental track on his own, Shiny Collarbone, to playing synths, keys, guitar, and doing background vocals. It honestly amazes me that one man did so much on one record. In the end, Notes on a Conditional Form is a solid album. People on the internet have been discussing how chaotic it can be, both negatively and positively, as well as how some tracks may have fallen flat and should not have been included. But I think that all 22 tracks on here show how much the 1975 had matured over the years. Check it out if you have not already, and tune in next week where I will be reviewing the difference between Hell and Home by Counterparts, as well as having a very special guest on the show. That's it for this episode of Music Minute. If you wanted to check out the songs I mentioned from this album, there will be a playlist in the description of this video, and this playlist also has songs that I've mentioned from previous reviews, so be sure to check it out, and I'll talk to you next week.